we should go back to whatever vamp we start at the top.
Okay.
You know,
on the day we recorded this album, Juan and I had been friends for 21 years and 11 days. We met in 1993 as sophomores transferring to Douglas Anderson School of the Arts in Jacksonville, Florida. I first noticed Juan's saxophone case on the bus ride to school. Then we bumped into each other in homeroom, and finally, we met in First Jazz Band later that day. It was a case of, okay, you're new, I'm new, we're both serious about the same thing, let's be friends. That kicked off 3 years of carpool listening sessions and weekend jams in Juan's living room. We'd play along to Abersold CDs while Juan's parents watched from the couch. We discovered 251s together, attended our first jam sessions together, made All-State Jazz Band together. Anxious to begin our recording careers, we even booked studio time and hired the best band we could afford. It was a proud day. We made our first tape. We went our separate ways for college, and while we always stayed in touch, we saw less and less of each other each year. Somehow 15 years went by without playing together. Until this January, when Juan visited me in Los Angeles. We pulled out the old play-alongs and jammed like it was 20 years ago. It was as if no time had passed. We still could finish each other's ideas and sync up like we played together consistently. I knew we should document this for real. So I lured Juan back for another visit, booked a studio in Hollywood, and recruited two of my favorite players in town. The plan was to just go in with little structure and record some of the tunes we used to play. But I had an agenda. I wanted to capture conversation, not competition. There's a rich legacy in jazz of two tenor recordings. One kind is the cutting contest, where the material tends to be fast and challenging and each player tries to outdo the other. I was more interested in the two men talking kind. My model was Coleman Hawkins encounters Ben Webster. Using that old Hollywood sound as a reference, we all set up in one room so we could see and hear each other. One reason new jazz recordings don't sound like old ones is that modern studios isolate players to allow for editing later. But if you're not going to edit, why isolate? I wanted that sound you only get when each player's instrument bleeds onto all the microphones. I wanted that big room reverb. I also wanted to capture what came instinctively, so we stuck to first takes and no overdubs. Right would be what happened on the first pass. And the material? Well, what can I say? Juan and I share an affinity for a broad range of music. The standards were a perfect vehicle to transport us back to familiar territory, but of course, I ended up writing a few tunes just days before the session, and even arranging one of my favorite Police songs. We recorded all of it in one day, but the end result was two unique statements. So in the spirit of an old album, I grouped them as side A and side B. I think you'll understand why when you listen. To us, all this music exists in the same space. It's all approached with the same diligence and enthusiasm for creating in the moment. From the swing tunes to the sting tune, one thing was obvious. This feels familiar, like we've been here before.
All these grads who are playing this evening are immediately friends. That was the biggest thing concerning that they were the energy in the room and that we all respect each other. I mean, they're going like, man, great, you're great, you're great, no, you are fantastic, all that stuff. And the egos, you know, these are really big time players, and there's no ego. They're all about making great music. So ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to them. On saxophone, our saxophone section, Juan Roland.
Thank you. Thank you.
Next, we're going to switch gears. We have a couple people here. I'm the band who did not graduate from Dr. Sanderson, but have always been a part of Dr. Sanderson. The guitar players that I searched to get to play, one had to go on tour, and the other, his wife had a baby. I tell them, get your priorities right, you know? But we're thankful to have the wonderful and super talented, plays all over the world, James Hogan, who taught here for a while. As you may or may not know, Phil Woods passed away this year, a great icon in the jazz world. And this ballad is called Lifelong Friends. And the gentleman who's been playing is on Barry Sachs, who did not graduate from Dr. Sanderson, but he's one of ours because his mom got a job with the National Symphony and had to move. So anyway, he graduated from North Carolina School of the Arts, and he's always been a part of this. He's one of the guys you saw in the film, playing, leading the group, the small combo group that you saw. And he's just a dynamite person. Just released a new CD, Cowboys and Frenchmen, and as well as many others, which will be available afterwards at the table for any and all that want to do that. And ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome Mr. Barry Sachs, Owen Broder.
three. One, two, three. Woo!
Welcome to Jazz at Lincoln Center's 11th annual Essentially Ellington High School Jazz Band Competition and Festival.
Essentially Ellington is considered the Super Bowl of high school jazz competitions.
This year, about 1,000 bands responded from the U.S., Canada, and American schools abroad.
This is the highest level of American music in terms of ensemble playing.
We're singing this music, we're dancing to this music, we're trying our hardest to get this, and it just seems like we're not there.
You guys aren't feeling the beat together.
We were too loose. We were too squirrely. It was just, the band wasn't ready.
What did I just say, TJ?
Ruben, no!
We don't have any time for you not to be on task, okay?
My worst fear is probably failure.
What you did in your little fish pond here is nothing. I said, you're going to go in the ocean. A shark, hello!
During the past 2 days, we've heard fabulous performances by 15 bands that judges selected as finalists.
You've been given an opportunity of a lifetime, you need to seize it.
We sound good, but is that really good enough?
My heart was just beating. Boom, 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 boom.
When I call your name, I want your band to stand up where they're seated. First place from the bands you all heard tonight.
When you love the music, you take risk. When you love anybody, you take a risk.
So we're going to recreate this. You gotta understand, we had one rehearsal last night and doing all this music. The level of musicianship that's on the stage is incredible, and doing all different types of styles, including Ellington and everything else. So this is called Black and Tan Fantasy that we actually played there at Ellington. With many of the same players. fantastic solos and a lot better than what we did in New York. Next, we're going to do a Gordon Goodwin's tune. Gordon Goodwin, you may or may not know, is a great arranger and a composer and a film composer. I really started digging his music when he first came on the scene. We tried to get him here much earlier in his career, and then we were able to do it later in the career. And he remembered talking to me on the phone, trying to get a commission, all stuff. And he worked with my son at Grammy Camp, and we kept in contact over the years. So he came back from one concert, and we put together all my professional friends. And David Champagne was part of that group because he was graduating and playing professionally with myself and others, and it's all right. And so we're going to do a little Latin and feature David on the horn appointe. Thank you. I know it's a long concert, but aren't you having fun?
Oh, yeah.
We saw about Bob Reynolds earlier. Bob's played all over the world. He was John Mayer, and he's Marvin Puppy, and everybody, and on The Voice, and all this other stuff. Bob was the very first person who ever wrote anything for the Jazz Band. And if I remember right, I hope I'm right, his first piece they ever written for this Jazz Band was called Trial and Error. and his estimation was literally a trial and error, but it was a great piece. It was wonderful. He has since gone on to write many, many, many things and been on ASCAP's Young Composers and everything else and awards. Has at least 60 years more. Yeah, he's got a bunch. Check them online, you'll see. Bob Reynolds music, okay? And then everybody else on here has got tons. Theo just released a new one. Daniel Dickinson just released a new one. Who else? Corey's got one coming out. And Jameson, of course, and everybody else here got something out there. So they're making music for you, for the world to enjoy. So please invest in that music, because there's nothing better than live music, but also that playing your cars even better. When you're driving around the street, we don't have like musicians. So next we're going to do another piece he wrote that was adapted by the University of North Texas, was it 1 o'clock band? The University of North Texas, 1 o'clock band? It was one of the bands at the University of Texas. Adapted this for his tune for Jazz Band, and this is called Summerlight. And it featured Bob Reynolds.
Thank you.
greatest things as far as my career here at Douglas Anderson is that the teachers are so creative. And I love to be do creative things and envision in my brain and then bring it to life, that type of thing. There's nothing better than and then this concept, and this happened? I'm dead and go to heaven already. I got to thank these guys from the bottom of my heart to make the sacrifice from their families and from the distances they came. I mean, literally all over the world. I mean, how blessed am I? Just trust me and leave me alone and it'll all happen. Can you imagine that now, doing that? And that was extravaganza. This is this year's 30th anniversary. One of those conversations when we started getting into School of the Arts was that we need to have a brand or a logo, and we've grown into various ones over the years. The very first one you see up here, which used to be on this front here, is the original logo for the School of the Arts when we had four arts area. Now we have eight or more now. I came up with the creative concept, and I had a friend of mine who did my album artwork named Bruce Floyd. I said, Bruce, I want this, this, and this, and this. Can you make it come to life? And again, there you are. Wow. And the newest one you see here with the DA, because it says all about Douglas Anderson, didn't say anything else. So I'm appreciative for letting me be creative and do those things, and the teachers have fallen into that. Things that I've asked them to do or create or become collaborative with us. I mean, we do a lot of collaborative things here. And it's such a success in growing the community and to make your name brand all over the world for the school. And the various cheerleaders, I mean, we don't have a better cheerleader than Mrs. Cornelius, and that's what I call her, our number one cheerleader. So we're not quite, we're talking about name brands. I mean, if I say the name Satchmo, you know who that is. Who? Louis Armstrong. Well, we have our own Louis Armstrong here, and we're doing a portrait of Louis Armstrong, and his name is Alfonso Horn. Incredible talent as well as everybody else up there. But he's going to do this, and we did this with Wynton Marcellus at Ellington. And I believe, aren't you the sub for Wynton? Yes. He is the official sub for Wynton Marcellus. One of them. Hey, just to be in that. Hey, Alfonso, can you come do the gig for me? You know? So anyway, I hope you truly enjoy this. This is a great, great, great piece.
Thank you.
can't thank you so much for staying this long. I hope that you've had as much fun as I have.
Oh, yeah.
Again, this is like once in a lifetime event, really. I mean, if Don can create this again with his students and everybody else, and and I know that he will. Okay. I better think it's the birth of my son. Okay. I gotta tell you, I can't thank these guys again enough for making this commitment to be here and to come together. You know, I sent the music out, they've got such busy schedules, I don't even know if they even had time to practice it. And then do this in one evening, a 2.5-hour rehearsal. We won't tell anybody, but we know who did. No, just kidding. But to do this and to make this kind of commitment, my goal was to show everybody's talent in this band. And the next piece we're doing is we're closing out. And those who haven't heard yet, you will hear. And so everybody in this band, you've heard their singular contribution to music in the jazz world this evening. And that's very rare on any concert to see that. And I can't thank them much. How much I appreciate it, how much they're loved. How blessed I am. Ray. I'm going to do like we did in Ellington. I'm turning it over, I can't call them students anymore. I'm turning it over to the grads, and James is going to take you out. I'm going to listen. Thank you.